What is up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. Before we get into the topic, I have three things that I need to talk about before we can start. The first thing is, for the past 2 weeks, there has been someone working on the roof of our apartments. So if you hear loud noises, I'm sorry. I've tried to wait. I've pushed back videos for days, hoping that this person will be done working on the roof, but he is still working on it. So we're just gonna have to push through it today. The second thing is I am actually doing No Shave November this year. I did it 2 years ago, barely grew anything. I'm hoping I have a better result by the end of this month, but just so you know, for this month of November, the videos, I'm gonna look more and more like a billy goat, basically. The third and most exciting thing is that my podcast with my brother, the Work for Change podcast, is finally available, so I'm gonna link it down in the description. We just have the YouTube video up right now. We are still working on getting approved on iTunes and Spotify and all the other places you would put podcasts, but if you are interested, I would seriously love for you to check it out. It is so important to me. It's something that I've worked so hard on. I really wanna be able to bring you guys just awesome stories, not of just of weight loss people, but people that have, you know, changed their lives and worked hard to change their lives, and hopefully I can bring value to you guys. And I'm really excited about it. So if you could take a second to go down there and check that podcast out, I would be very, very grateful. Let's get into the topic of today's video, which we're gonna be talking about a question that I get almost daily, and especially the more that I've been talking about trying to maintain weight loss, right? Like, I'm all about right now trying to help people lose weight in a way that's maintainable and something that you can do for the rest of your life. So with talking about that more, I'm having a lot of people ask me, what was it like transitioning from weight loss, like thinking in your mind, I need to lose weight, to transitioning into I need to maintain this, and then maybe even put on a little bit of weight to add muscle. So today I want to talk about, you know, my experience, and is hopefully I'll be able to give you some tips on how you can go through this experience and hopefully have the best results possible. So the first thing that I want to talk about is probably the biggest mistake that people seem to make when they decide to kind of, you know, end their weight loss. They're happy with the weight that they are, and they either want to maintain or they want to add on maybe some weight and pack on some muscle. The big issue that I've seen with people that are trying to switch from losing weight to maybe maintaining or gaining weight is that they are no longer intentional with their diet. What I mean by this is that when we are losing weight, a lot of us are obviously very aware of the food we're putting into our body. A lot of us are maybe tracking all the macros that we're eating. We are very intentional about our food. What a lot of people do is once they decide I'm gonna start gaining weight, they kind of just YOLO their diet. They decide I'm gonna eat whatever I want, however much I want. I'm not gonna track anymore. I'm no longer going to be weighing myself. I'm just gonna, you know, I'm just gonna go for it because I'm done with the diet and now I can do whatever. That is the worst way to go about things. Something that helped me out and what I think is smart for a lot of people is I thought of, you know, the diet when I was going to be gaining weight or maintaining as just a continuation of what I was doing before. Now, there's obviously flaws in this. If you are somebody that is doing something that's very unsustainable, you're really doing something that you cannot wait to finish and be done with, this obviously is not gonna work for you. So that's why I stress so hard and try and push sustainable dieting, something that you can see yourself doing in the long run, because once you do hit that weight where you're okay with and you want to maybe either maintain there or you want to gain size, all you have to do is just eat the same things but just add more calories to that. But again, if you're doing something that's very unsustainable or very just very different, maybe you're drinking shakes only to lose the weight, that's obviously something that you can't just maintain and do a little bit more of. So that obviously there's a flaw in that, but that's why I'm so passionate about having people diet in a sustainable way. Another thing that was incredibly beneficial for me was I continued to monitor myself. So monitoring my weight, I obviously still looked in the mirror, made sure I wasn't going completely overboard. Now, the reason that I think this is really helpful is if you kind of decide, okay, I'm gonna put my head in the sand, I'm not gonna look at how much I weigh, I don't wanna look in the mirror anymore, that's when things can get out of hand, and then you don't realize it, and then you start to think, well, I need to diet again, and then you're kind of just stuck in that, I lost a lot of weight and then I gained a little bit and I want to lose it again. And then I lost all the weight again and then I gained a little bit, I want to lose it again. So instead of doing that, just make sure that you're monitoring yourself. You know, obviously you're going to be putting on a little bit of weight, but as long as that's, you know, in a very slow way, you're not going to be tripping out and freaking out when you see the scale jump up 20 pounds because you haven't weighed yourself in 2 months. So I would say it's very beneficial to continue weighing yourself. Now, I'm not saying you have to weigh yourself for the rest of your life. I don't weigh myself all the time, but I still still make sure that I step on the scale, make sure everything's, you know, I'm not completely going overboard, which now that it's been 5 years, I know what I need to eat, I know where I need to be, but for the first few months, especially after my Men's Physique show, that was incredibly beneficial for me. Another thing that helped me out a ton was I continued to do cardio. Now, a lot of people fall into the trap of thinking when I'm losing weight, I should be doing a lot of cardio, literally like excess, more than they probably should. And then once they decide either I'm gonna maintain here or I wanna put on a little bit of muscle, I'm just gonna stop doing cardio completely. Now, for me, what helped me out a lot was to continue that cardio because again, that makes your energy expenditure higher so you're able to eat a little bit more. So again, it's harder to go over on your calories because you're continuing that cardio and obviously it's just good to do cardio no matter what size you are. It's gonna be working on your heart. That is a good thing. And when I say cardio, I wanna make it clear, I'm not just saying, you know, doing the treadmill or doing the stairs, whatever that might mean for you. If that's going on walks around your neighborhood, if that's going on hikes, if it's going on runs, doing rowing, whatever cardio is for you, just continue doing that no matter where you are in your journey. It is super helpful. Another important thing is to realize how important of a piece of the journey this is, because obviously weight loss, that's gonna happen in a year, 2 years, 3 years, right? It's only gonna take a certain amount of time, but maintaining that weight and maintaining that weight loss is going to be for the rest of your life. So just understand how incredibly important this is. And it's not a joke, it's not like something that just kind of happens. It is hard work that you need to work on. And it's not just something that kind of falls into your lap. It will take time. You will have ups, you will have downs. This is the long haul of the journey, right? I just want to share a couple of the truths with you guys that has happened with me in this, you know, 5 year journey that I've gone through. So for the first big part of my journey, I was tracking every single meal, every single gram and ounce of food that I was eating. And I can say since basically my show over 2 years ago, I have not tracked really a full day since then. So now I am just so versed in understanding what my body needs. First off, like I can just kind of feel, and it might sound like hippy dippy or whatever, but I can just feel how hungry I am, how active I've been for that day, and I just eat according to that. Now there's certain things that I still avoid. I still try to avoid drinking my calories because I know that no matter what, like I can drink a ton of calories that I do not need. So that is something that has been something that has stuck with me since basically day one of my journey. I just don't drink calories unless I'm putting a little bit of something in my coffee because I can't drink black coffee, sue me, I can't do it. But that has been something that has stayed consistent. You know, liquid calories is still something that I avoid, and there are still things that I just really can't have because I know I can't control myself. Like I've recently realized that I can't buy boxes of cereal because I know for a fact if I buy a box of cereal, I'm gonna eat that box in probably one day. And that's just not good for anybody. So, you know, there's things that you learn on the journey that from day one might be the same and they might change. Again, everybody is different. The other thing I've learned is to not use exercise as a punishment for overeating, because that will just send you down a spiral of somewhere you don't wanna be. Exercise is to improve your life, not to punish yourself for a mistake that you might have made with food. It doesn't work, one, and it's just not healthy, and it's not gonna make you feel any better. You're not gonna get off that treadmill after you've done 2 hours of cardio because you ate that box of cereal, right? And be like, yeah, man, I totally burned that off, I'm really happy. No, you're gonna get off the treadmill exhausted, really hungry, and then you're just, in your mind, you just start struggling because you're like, well, I already ate that whole box of cereal. I don't need any more food, but you're literally like super lethargic. And as you can probably tell, this is something that I did. This is how I was when I was struggling with binge eating. That's exactly what I would do. It doesn't work and it's not healthy. I don't recommend doing that, but it's a trap that we all fall into. You think I need to exercise this stuff off that I just consumed. It's not good. Exercise is to improve the quality of your life, not to punish yourself for overeating. Another thing that I've learned is that you cannot be afraid of watching the number on the scale jump pretty high. Like I honestly fluctuate, I can fluctuate 10 to 15 pounds in one day. I know that sounds crazy. I think it has to do with just with my loose skin, I think plays a really big role in that. But just understand, especially this started happening once I started incorporating more calories into my diet, the weight on the scale fluctuates tremendously. So understand that's probably gonna happen Don't be freaked out. As long as you know that you're doing everything that I said in the video, you are being intentional with everything that you're doing, that number, no matter how intentional you are, especially like if you eat a ton of veggies and your stomach is still full and you weigh yourself, you are going to be a lot higher on the scale than if you waited and went to the bathroom and then weighed yourself. So just understand, you will see the number on the scale fluctuate very drastically. That is normal. But there you guys go. That's a couple of the tips and tricks and things that I've learned, you know, through my journey. Hopefully it helps you guys out. I hope this video is able to make sense. I have been trying to film it for like an hour, but as you can hear, it's just really hard here right now. So again, I really hope that helps you out, and I hope that this video makes sense. But with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. There was one other thing that I wanted to say. Oh yeah. Look how buff I am.
Obey the warning signs, and when there are flashing lights or wigwags, don't attempt to cross until they come to a complete stop.